What's poppin', guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. Now in this tutorial, I'm gonna show you guys exactly how to create really, really cool text animations in Premiere Pro. So I'm also very excited to tell you guys that every Monday we'll be uploading Premiere Pro tutorials. So if you guys have any suggestions you would like to see in future episodes, make sure to let me know down in the comments and maybe your topic will get added onto the list. I already have an entire list of topics I'm gonna cover. They're not the simplest ones, I'm gonna admit that to you guys. It's kinda in the same style as Vegas Pro. When it comes to masking, 3D modeling, that's all for in the future. Right now we're gonna hop into Premiere Pro. I'm gonna show you guys exactly how to animate text. If you guys are excited, make sure to hit the like button down below, subscribe if you're new watching, and I would say let's get started right after the intro. Alright guys, so as you can see right now we are in Premiere Pro and we haven't really opened anything yet because we want to work with projects and sequences. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on file, we're going to hit new, and we're going to open up a new project. Now let's just give this a name, for example, text animations, like that. Then we're gonna hit okay. So now as you can see, this is our workspace where we can work in and create our video. But for today, I'm gonna focus on some text animations. So the first thing we need to do is we need to create a new sequence right away first. So then we're gonna go to the file as well. We're gonna hit new, and then we're going to click on sequence. So here we need to pick the resolution. I would recommend going to HTV, and then I would pick also the 1080p 24 frames. And I would hit okay. So now we have our preview screen right here visible and everything like that. So the first thing we need to do is we need to insert some text. Now, of course, in Vegas Pro, you would go to media generators and then go to text. But right here, it is actually pretty straightforward. We're gonna click on this T icon that says the type tool, and then we can just directly click onto our preview and we can type something that we want. So let's type in our name, because let's say that we're going to recreate a really cool lower third. So then what we need to do is we need to change it up a little bit more by changing the font and all that. So highlight everything. So right here on the left, we have a menu that kind of looks pretty complicated, but it's pretty simple. We're gonna start off by changing up the font of this text file. So we're gonna click on this drop down icon, and then we're gonna basically choose any font that we like, or you can just highlight it and then you can just use your arrows to browse through the fonts. I'm going to just keep it basic like that. Okay, so now that we have chosen the font, we need to position this in the bottom corner. So if you want to change up the size of the font as well, right here you have your font menu. If you're going to highlight your text, if you go to that dot, if you drag that to the right, that is going to make your text bigger or smaller. Now what we're going to do is we're going to select this icon, the selection tool, so we can have this and position this on the screen. Okay, so for a lower third, we would actually position it right here, like nice in the corner. But I would recommend to place this a little bit higher because we will have some smaller text underneath it appearing right here as well. So now that we have the text positioned, we can also just go ahead and duplicate this text layer in our timeline. If we zoom in just a little bit like that. So if you want to duplicate your text layer, you'll just want to press Alt and you want to drag this one on top. So we have two text layers. Now we can also change up the second one, for example, Premiere Pro tutorial. Now we're gonna make this one a little bit smaller as well. So select your text, make this one a little bit smaller like that. And we're gonna also position it below the text. So if you scroll down a little bit on this menu, right here it says transform. Right here, this is the position. So this is horizontal and this is vertical. So if you go to vertical, if you drag that one down, you wanna have that below the text, as you can see like that. I think in my opinion, it could be a little bit smaller as well. For example, like that. That looks really, really nice. And then we're gonna place it a little bit more closer to the text. All right, so this is basically what we created so far. We have our nice lower third, we have our text right here, but we need to animate it as well. Right here, we have this position icon. We're gonna click on there. What that allows us to do is we can create keyframes right here in this window, because this is our marker. If I drag this one to the right, as you can see below the preview screen, that's going to follow along. That's our marker in the timeline. Okay, so we're gonna start off with the top text. So I'm gonna move the bottom text away for just right now. We need to work with keyframes. We're gonna make this text in slide in from the bottom to this position. So what we're gonna do is first, I'm going to create a keyframe 1 second into the video. So I'm gonna do it like that. The text is now in the screen on this position and we wanna keep it right there. So what we need to do now is right here in our timeline, we need to create a keyframe. So then it's going to key to this position. Okay, so in order to create keyframes, it is pretty simple. Next to the opacity, we have this really, really small icon which says add add or remove keyframe. So right now we're going to click on here, and right now, as you can see, it created a keyframe in our timeline. So now what we need to do is we need to go back for now, and then we just need to drag this text down. So we're going to scroll down a little bit to our transform menu, and we're going to pick the vertical one, and we're going to just drag that down, as you can see, until the text is out of the screen. Okay, so let's play it back and let's see what we have in total. Okay, so as you can see right now, this is the keyframe that we made where it is completely in the screen, and this is obviously the first one where it's out of the screen. Okay, so now that looks really, really cool, but if you want to have this one a little bit faster, just drag this keyframe a little further to the beginning. That's going to make it faster. Okay, so while this one is sliding, we're going to also make the second one slide in. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the same. We're going to click on position right here. And this is the timeline where we will be working in. Position this one a little bit lower. And we're going to make this one slide in from the left instead from the bottom. So what we need to do is we're going to the very beginning, and then we're going to pick the horizontal marker. Okay, so now we need to also time it. So I'm going to also do it like this. And what we need to do now is we need to make this guy slide in again and make sure that it's nice and aligned like that, and then it creates a keyframe automatically. So let's play it back right now. As you can see, that looks really, really cool. We have our name and we have Premiere Pro tutorial, but we can just have something else, for example, our Instagram. You can place like Twitter right here in the big text, and then below that your username, anything similar to that, but this is just showing you how to animate it. Okay, but I think this one looks pretty plain and pretty basic, and it could be a little better. First, we're going to go to the bottom one of our Alex Halford text layer, and then we're gonna select all our keyframes in our timeline. Just drag your mouse, hold your left mouse button, and we're gonna right click on both keyframes, and we're going to place this one on continuous bezier. So let's see what that looks like. Okay, it makes it a lot smoother, but the cool thing is that we can actually make this one fade in like really quick then, and then just slowly goes into position. So we can also do that for the bottom one for Premiere Pro. We're gonna go to our timeline of our keyframes, select them all, right click, and you want to hit, of course, the temporal interpolation, and we're going to put this one on continuous bezier like that. To make this a lot smoother is we're going to go to the position icon, but next to it is a little small arrow. We're going to click on that, and that's going to open up this line, and let's drag this guy a little bit more to the left so we can see what we're doing. Okay, so right here what we can do is we can manipulate the motions. So let's select all of this so we have the line selected, and if you put this one up, for example, let's see what that looks like. As you can see, if I mute this one for a second, it slides in slowly, and then boom, it goes really quick into place. As you can see right now, it looks really cool. Just go back, select all the both lines, then you see these really small two dots. If you move your mouse like that, you can see you can create like all kinds of like motions. So let's make it a little bit more of a buildup like that. As you can see, it looks really, really nice, but we can also do that for the first one. So let's drag that one up as well. It slides in, stops for a second, and then boom, it goes back into place. And we can also do that for the other text layer. So go to the position button, click on this really small icon, and then we see right here this line. So select everything. So this is the end frame. So if you want to have your text go quicker when it's already in the screen, going into its final position, you want to pick the last keyframe. If you want to have it reverse, if you want to have it come in really quick and then go to slow, you just want to pick the first keyframe. So let's go ahead and select these and drag this one up. So let's see what that looks like. So let's move that layer out of the way. It comes in really quick. It slows down, and then it goes into the final position. So that is how to do it, guys. It is really, really simple. And if this tutorial went by too fast, make sure to pause or rewind it. If this was a little bit too quick, you guys get the point. This is how you animate it. And of course, if you select both of these, you can just mess around with it until you're happy with it, until your lower third looks really, really nice. So this is what we have created so far. It looks really, really cool. So that's it, guys. This is how you create cool text animations in Premiere Pro. Oh, and by the way, guys, in future videos, we're gonna also talk about 3D modeling. And if you're looking for 3D scripts or anything related to that, or visuals, overlays, make sure to check out Production Crate. Since I've been working with Production Crate and using their content, almost 80,000 people start using Production Crate. It's completely for free, but if you want to upgrade, there's always a $4 a month plan. But like I mentioned, guys, make sure to check out their website for awesome overlays, visual effects. They have sound, they have music, they have everything you can imagine. Like I've mentioned, it's completely for free. Just sign up for a free account and start downloading downloading, no watermarks whatsoever. But they also have a monthly $4 membership for more exclusive stuff. And you have to check it out, guys. It's crazy and also works in Premiere Pro. So guys, that's it for this video. Now you guys know how to animate text in Premiere Pro. You can use all kinds of variations and you can use this as lower thirds. You can also use this to promote like a promo code, have like any text slide on the screen. It is that simple. I want to thank you guys for watching. And I want to thank you guys for the continued support. And I'll see you guys in my next video.